Gabriel.
Yeah, man.
I'm dazed and confused, bro.
I know, so am I. I just don't know where to put all these boxes.
Too many, you know? It's like, what do you mean all these boxes, man? You only did like 3 boxes.
There's stuff all over the place, though.
Stuff all over the place, man. I'm dazed and confused.
I'm confused myself.
I've been working so hard, I don't even care about my hair anymore, you know? All right, so we're going to listen to this. It's going to cut off at some moment. I hope you understand that.
We got to play the soundtrack to this moment.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, it's true. Listen, man, you know what? It's like... What's going on, dude? Just talk to me, man. Talk to me. This fucking thing is like, right, talk to me, bro. I want to hear what you got to say, man. I want to hear what you've got to say because...
I'm confused about what, you know, what's going to be your next step.
The next step. The next step is the white rose.
The white rose.
The white rose. That's the next step. The white rose.
Elaborate a little bit.
It's a nice rose, the white rose. It's really white. It's a white rose. Is that enough of an elaboration?
What do you mean when you say the white rose?
Well, it's a code word. I'm not at liberty to speak freely on this code word that was, passed on to me.
Oh, it's something like swordfish.
Yeah, I guess so. You could say that. You know. But you know what? Gabriel, you're busting my balls. You're not talking. You're not saying anything.
Well, you mentioned White Rose and you said you can't talk about it. So now you got me confused and dazed. I'm wondering.
Now you're dazed and confused along with me, huh?
And I'm wondering, what does this White Rose mean?
Ah. I'm too dazed and confused to deal with it. I'll tell you after the video, but I don't want certain people knowing what I'm talking about. You know? I really don't want that. I don't want to disclose the meaning of the white rose. I will tell you afterwards, though.
So where do you see the movement going in 2010?
I see movement in the movement. I see a family of souls. This is what I see, a family of souls. Yeah. That's a simple way of putting it, but that's what I see. I see a family of souls converging. But it's not just the movement of which I sire that I speak of. For all life is movement, all life is energy. So you don't have to belong to a particular family to reap the benefits of someone from another family influencing you or inspiring you. It's a very simple thing to understand. We all have the capacity to have such an open-mindedness. But somehow, we feel insecure. We feel insecure about nurturing such an open-mindedness. We feel that somehow we will lose. That we will lose grasp of our own sense of individuality. Now that's a funny one right there, individuality. Can't say I believe in individuality. I think individuality is one of the last illusions. Not to say that every personality, every soul is not unique. Just the idea, the concept behind the term individuality. Individuality. In a divisive duality. Divisive duality. In a divisive duality. Basically, this is what individuality is. The only reason you want to shine as an individual is because you want to see how you stack up against the next person. But this is why, even when one achieves what one desires, one finds that one is still plagued with suffering. With a great and great and greater sense even of sense of incompletion. Sense that somehow you are not satisfied. Because you are looking, we are looking in all the wrong places. Instead of to that one place where we can find what we are seeking. All these things have been said in the past in different ways, are being said right now in different ways, and will continue to be said in different ways. It's not so much the different way in which they are said that matters. What matters is the will, and in Sanskrit, ichcha, the active will. The ichcha, the active will of the soul, of the spirit soul. But I have a different idea about soul. I don't think everyone is a soul. We're all spirits, but we're not all souls. Soulship is something that one evolves into. And it may take however long it may take for this to happen. These are deep concepts, and they are not just coming off the top of my head. Though it may appear to be that way, but it's not.
Well, you mentioned this before. I think people want to know is how can they evolve into becoming that soul?
The answers, well, some people are already souls. They don't even know it sometimes. A lot of the times. Based upon, and some people aren't. People that aren't, and I know I'm speaking in simplistic terms, I'm purposely speaking in a simplistic manner. If for too long, these spiritual, if you will, metaphysical concepts have been shrouded in needless secrecy. When this world is going to blossom, must come from a place. We already know the answer of true being. Because only with a true being can you love. So I'd say that being a true being is of more immediate importance than all of a sudden claiming some universal love that you know nothing of. Ashe.
Oh, shit.